Pretty sweet. So today deals is that I basically installed SweetFX that caused my game to look less bad. And this will be basically goal for today's stream to chill with game that looks nicer than usual. Okay, for some weird shit reason, Tyranny opened for me twice. Which is going to cause a lot of troubles. Okay, I clicked exit. Okay, and we are here. Yeah, I ended in this sad grind where we basically do sad grinding. As you can see, plus one subterfuge. And this is going to be the case for next eternity. By the way, people probably think that's not actually the strat to play the game and you can just play normally, but that's lie. Like, honestly, more things you optimize in your game, including your own gameplay and playstyle, the better. Trust me, guys. You see, this might seem like nothing, but once you grind it to very high levels, this nothing became something. It's pretty easy. Okay. How far away we are from subterfuge? 1 minute. 35. Okay, I was mostly wondering if... Spawn? Sadly, there is like nowhere to run. And by stalling this fight, I basically gain more XP. See? I just casting spells in one place, and it's completely legal. Make sure you can kill him with some lightning spell. One moment. This is on CD. This is last healing this combat I can cast. Because now everyone is full. Of course save, and of course learn instruction. Party spell slot plus 1 and the lore experience plus 20%. This is extremely important. You basically speedrun for it. Now you can build whatever you want. It doesn't really matter. So even if that was pretty boring 10-minute fight, it was extremely strat heavy. Look at this pretties. Yeah, basically useless. Never mind. Sadly, a lot of aspects of the game is painfully similar, which drastically lowers replayability. Okay, we technically can have long relearning subterfuge from interactions because we have 50. And by having 50 subterfuge at this early levels, we pretty much eliminated ourselves. From any subterfuge related problems. Look at this. Curious. Let me pause. Back you guys. My subterfuge. Like, honestly, these guys painfully don't deserve it. I am painfully close to this subterfuge level. But somehow can't have it. Late 84? Yes, okay. That's okay. Each enemy can give some pool of XP, but not all of it. For example, now I have 103. And that guy gave me 27. From what guy is pretty okay. And another 27. Pretty good. You basically just wanna grind your levels in this. Like, you can literally get extra levels by doing that. Now this 27 will bring me very close to next level. Barik is not in the position that would benefit him greatly around him when that's still free XP. That will be level up. And this is, like always, some help. Okay. We might wanna block his floor, maybe? You, for sure, don't want your characters to grind the lore, unless they are mage. In our situation, Verse have fucking 5 party spell slots, and he's pretty good as mage. Like, this is only 20 points behind my character, and 10 points behind Lantif, who is actual mage. So, you know, you can make Verse a very good mage. Besides being as far from magic class as you can fucking possibly be with this bow.
Can't do that.
So you know what you can do? You can go there. Can you make spells in combat? On couch? In combat. Okay. Can I assign spells in combat? No. Okay, never mind. I didn't know, okay? Easy. Impenetrate, I cannot speak. Anyway. Oh, I... this favorite iron sword is junk. Good? No. This is very good. Heavy armor, but it doesn't matter. This cloth armor, but it's not that great. I mean, I would gladly replace his armor, but I'll better replace him. We literally replacing him whenever we can. He's way too fucking quick for your party. Anyway, now we are out of combat and we can... assign it. This is 15. We can basically reduce time. Oh, never mind. This cost 50. Okay, this increased might is always welcome. Also Friarbomb, you can have it. Also, it is important to not use this. Why? Because stronger spells you have, stronger they hit. And you wanna hit weak. By having weaker attack, you can stall fights, but you wanna have stronger stronger buffs. As strong as possible buffs, and as strong as possible healing. But as weak as possible attacks. This costs 25. So yeah, check if your attacks are not too strong. And that's it. Update. You wanna have stun attacks. Stun attacks are great because they immobilize enemies, which is very good. And yes, we're going to save. After such extensive crafting spells, you rather wanna save to not do it again. Okay, how far we are from level up? I might try to sneak a crit on him. Okay, that was good, I used his attack as cover from my healing. Now we can use spectral blur on our advantage, which will cause my dodges and parry to be more efficient. I don't see efficiency of these dodges and parries. The fuck spell didn't work. Level up. And that didn't stun. So we have to stall a little bit more. Unless this would first healing. Okay, now stun. This is prone. Okay, prone is good enough. If you run away from combat, enemy restore HP, so you can start this combat again and gain more XP. I can't farm quickness. Annoying. Health is very good when you cannot quickness. And here I wonder about expanded mind because that's two spell slots. However, boost morale, pulse rate sheet that constantly works is also very good. Oh yeah, it's good to know that boost morale works only in combat. Which makes this ability very hard to use for spellcrafting. Yes, because this is where you wanna use your abilities. Spellcrafting. Okay, since this character level up and Lantry level up, this have very far, this have very far, we can just steamroll them. It's a little bit less fun because you play normally instead of looking for any loophole. However, it's still pretty fun. No, that's lame. Electroshock. Count. Bow. Actually, you should probably dodge boost a lot. Nice, point of lore. Oh, I have a turnet of AI, so I can basically spellcast forever in one place.
You got
which is also extremely good. Okay, spectral door. Heal. Quicken. Heal. Barry could be useful.
I will aid you.
Yes. 8 is exactly what we need, because these guys think they can fucking win something. Huh, 100 weapon. I had no idea we used this. Blur yourself. Blur. Heal. Blur. Blur. Lightning. Vigor. Cross. This probably will kill him soon, so never mind, that's 2 damage. Let's stun them. Control vigor, parry. Very good.
You got it.
Oh, we gained some dodge XP. Nice. Akbarik, very famous spellcaster. Yeah, this lore will never go any further, but Parry will level up soon. Okay then, let's destroy these fuckers. Slowly and with boring spells. And don't worry, this don't kill him. Actually, can we like run? Run, 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 right, run, run, please, run. Okay, he's rooted. Don't worry, dear, we'll save you. Okay, that was decent. But I kind of fucked up. I mean, I should not play this that long, but it's fun. I honestly wonder if I can level up to max in first battle, for example, or you know, something like King of Stahl. This is probably useless. Yes, it is. What a monster. By the way, now we are under a boost morale. Lantry, you are casting heal? Yes. Okay, so I will cast this on Vers and Lantry. Now you are still under boost morale. I was hoping I could get her to 50. Fuck, Lantry was at 60, I could use that. You see, when you like boost morale to go over threshold, in Lantry case 60, you can quickly cast... I don't know, I was in combat, never mind. But you could quickly craft new spells that are stronger than you can access. Later, when you get more items, you will be able to connect so many books together that you will be crafting spells much, 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 much stronger than your character can legally afford. And these are really extreme numbers. Okay. This character didn't level up, and this character didn't level up.
Just point me in the right direction.
Her lore is not that important. Actually, let me take it on my character. You have to always consider who you will have in your pack. You cannot exchange your main character. That is only 6p. As you can see, he is now in full HP. It's frozen solid? No, it's just frost. Yeah, this is basically what you can do. Actually, I'm not sure if this will improve my athletics. No, it did not. Okay, this is quick cast. No. Frost effect should hold him for long, but we want a double effect. See if. Fucker. I already have my lore point. Lantry have bonus lore XP, so we will send him now. I mean, I will probably destroy him now. It's just, you know, obstacle at this point. Let's go. That spell failed. And we can run for it. I understand for most of you it might be very boring, but I honestly don't care. Like, you see, we elite pro gamers. Are able to stomach. Okay, during his stun, I will use this time to book myself. In case of lore, that's useless, but in case of these controls, control lightning will level up soon. If that stun him, we run. If not, I will probably kill him. Okay. This is also double stun, I'm not sure if that's 2 times longer or not. My bad. But it doesn't matter. Yeah, half XP. In case of lore, do we have some handy levels? Elantric would level. I go again with him. This is impaling throw. Big self buffing. Actually assisting healer.
I'll take care.
Heal.
Consider it done.
Blur. Lord plus one.
I'll take care. As you command.
Like this, again, this is very good XP. I should not complain. By the way, his every damage roll will scale my control vigor. Okay, how much lore do we have? This is boosting. His lore is almost boosted by 6. It's only by 5, but that's already a lot. Surge of Glory. We can recast it. Well, maybe later. Let's go, double Frostmaid's power. Okay, let's take Verse and let's take Varric very close. Fuck my luck, I misclicked. Okay. Spell menu. We have 60. We take this spell. We remove this and we add this. Now we remove this and we add this. Perfect. 47-30. Okay. Healing touch. 35. Fuck. What else can I teach you? One of these useless attacks. Why not? Have your first fryer bomb or whatever. We need a BB. We need more party slots. Really, next level I gonna unlock myself two spell slots because I cannot play like this. Let me save. That was very good battle. Extremely good, super fucking hard battle. How long does it take? I'm already playing for fucking hour and I fight 3 enemies. Okay. Be right back. I need small break for toilet. Okay, I'm back to gaming. And honestly, yeah, as you can see, most of the settlers are extremely innocent and they don't even know what the fuck. However, some of these people are not willing to surrender to the love of Kairos, which is reasonable because Kairos is stupid. Honestly, I haven't played for a while, so I wanna make sure I don't leave something fun. That's one moment I'm gonna turn off the light, it's pretty late. Yeah, we will basically be finishing this after this map, which might take a few hours. I was out of combat.
I'll be your shadow.
Okay. Now. XP. Honestly, enemy should stop hitting me because it's only make me stronger. Oh, this game is sick. What a funny mechanics. So yeah, you wanna go to this to as close to these losers as possible. Save very quickly. And we'll start grinding. Look at this. You cannot make that shit up. My turn now. See you fuckers. That was a lot of XP. From subterfuge. Two levels. It was pretty sick.
direction.
And since we still have ability to grind it, I'm going to try. There's like no reason not to do this. Free XP. Alright, these two guys are stunned. Alright, that's quite problematic because we don't want her to die. Okay, very good XP. Enemies made me stronger again. Look at this control lives. Later you can respect your character and you will basically take off all this magic into skills you really care about. For example lore, and you will make her have 150 lore and like 10 in magic. Okay, now land return. Oh, I'm sorry. No, we don't want to load. That was perfect. Hardest part will be Barik, because he will most likely have to initiate fight. Yeah, this will be two levels of subterfuge, or at least one and a half. I see you boys like hide and seek. Okay, this is extreme already. And we just started. This didn't stun him. Okay. By okay, I mean tragedy. But we kind of expected this to happen. So it's not like complete tragedy because you kind of expect it. And as you can see, this subterfuge really leveled up. So you have no regrets, of course, like always. And his control life is out of this world. Mm-hmm. Last person. Yeah, that poison was very unlucky. Okay, I recently gave him a new spell. Okay, we'll blur him. We'll cast Quicken. And we can heal him. Do you have lore blocked? Okay, unblock lore. Nice. Where are you going? I like having AI turn it off because enemy cannot do anything stupid. Blur. Vigor. Heal. Vigor. Quicken. That's mistake. Okay, freeze. And now question, who should grind lore? Land we have it close, so at least one point would be very good. Okay. No, oh, fuck. Misclicks are deadly in this game. Okay, you wanna frost him. Control Vigor XP is counted for you once a person you buffed deals damage to enemy, which makes it extremely hard to get if you stall like me. Actually, why not? Let's regroup. I'm pretty sure both parties have an edge. Honestly, this is quite fun. Okay, I will stop now. We beat all three enemies today, so that was a lot of progress, I would say. I will save and